Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thank you so much for coming back this week and checking out our new video. It's an absolute pleasure to have you back with us. Now you may have seen some of my teasers the last few days about what this video was going to be about, and I tried not to reveal too much, but today is finally the day where we can tell you what the project is. So today we're going to be looking at Plex Meta Manager, or PMM for short. So what is PMM? Well, if you guys have used Plex for quite some time and you want to freshen up your libraries, you want to make it a little bit more user intuitive and something similar to the lines of Netflix, for example, in terms of the way libraries are presented, then this is going to be the add-on for you. Now, it is an independent application or technically a script, but we're going to be able to run it in Docker and we're going to be following some instructions. Now, the official documentation is the best place to follow the official guide, which you can find here on GitHub under Plex Meta Manager. But we've also written a guide ourselves on docs.ibracorp.io. So as you can see here, we've started to write up the guide that's going to accompany this video. So if you like, you can follow this particular guide, the written guide that we've done to match what our video is today. And if there's any confusion or anything you're not sure about, be sure to jump in our Discord and ask for some help. We're more than happy to help. We've also got the main developer of the application in there too. So hopefully we can answer your question. Alternatively, we always recommend checking out the official docs as well, as it can cover stuff a little bit more comprehensively that isn't necessarily shown in the video. And you can always find that under our useful link section here on our documentation pages. And just to give you a quick example of what Plex Meta Manager is capable of, here's what our collections are. So here we have some collections, for example, trending, we've got popular, top rated, you know, best of this year or best of that year, Oscar winning, etc., etc. And the beauty of this is that we will have these added and refreshed all the time. As a little bonus for you, we'll also be showing you how to get a seasonal collection like that for Christmas to automatically update and keep things moving and freshen up your library. So here's just a couple of the features that PMM can provide you. So you can create and update Plex collections using a variety of sources, including Tortuli. So if you wanted people to know what was popular on your Plex server, it would be able to do that. You can add media that you want that's in collections, for example, IMDb to top 250 movies, and have it added to Radar and Sonar for you through the script. You can have custom posters, custom content, add custom overlays, including 4K and HDR banners, using YAMLs to edit media metadata such as titles to sort titles and descriptions, and you can add custom episode orders for Plex via the YAMLs as well. So guys, if you're using Plex and you want to freshen up your library, give your users a more seamless experience and one that is constantly updating and has a bit of life to it, then this is going to be the video for you. So stick around and let's get stuck into it. Alright guys, so like I said, we're on the docs page now and we've got all of our instructions written out here that we're going to be following along to. Now before we start the video, I do need to make it very clear to you guys that I would consider this topic a little bit more advanced. So if you're a complete beginner to setting up libraries or setting up Plex, then please have a look at some of our other beginner oriented videos like, you know, Plex tips and tricks, things like that. So please be careful, make sure you're reading the instructions as we provide them, and on top of that, remember that you're taking the risk of messing up your library if you don't do things correctly, or if something goes wrong. So what we're going to do at this stage, as normal, is I'm going to move this documentation over to my other screen, and you guys can follow along with me if you like. The rest of it, we're going to be starting the install and just getting straight into it. Alright, so here we are on our Unraid server, Osiris. So as usual, the first place we're going to head to is the App Store. So let's go do that. Search for Plex Meta Manager. And you'll see the option here by Roland's repository. Once you've got it, go ahead and click on it and click to install. Now in the template, we're going to see various different options. Starting from the top to bottom, let's work them out. So the network type, for this one, it's not as important, but I would still highly recommend you set the custom Docker network. And that's because if you wanted to refer to Sonar and Radar or Plex via host name, it's going to make your life easier. So I always just do it anyway, adding it to our custom Docker network. For the time to run is exactly as it says. What time do we want this script to run? Now, keep in mind, depending on what setup you have, it can take quite some time to run this. So if you're not too worried about your processing time or impact on your server, then I guess you can pick any time you want, but preferably something overnight. And then on top of that, preferably a time that doesn't clash with your Plex scheduled tasks, for example, and that way you can sort of clean up after itself. Divider character, we don't need to change. You can leave that there. Screen width, we also don't really need to change. The config path, so that's going to be our app data location. Make sure that matches what you want. And that's pretty much it. Those are the options that we have to configure. Everything else is left as is. Once you're ready, go ahead and click apply. Now, under our Docker tab, we can see the application is here. The Docker container is there. We'll left click and click start. Or if you've got yours off the store, then it should already be started. However, it may stop, and the reason is it may not have a config file. The other thing you might notice is that even if we run it and click on logs, there's nothing going to be in the logs here. And the reason is because it's actually waiting to execute the script at the time that you have set. But this can make it difficult when troubleshooting because we can't actually see where it might be stuck if the script was to run. So what we've explained in our documentation, if necessary, is to left click, click on the console, and you can paste this command, python plexmetamanager.py -r. That will then execute the script manually, and then if there is anything wrong with your config, then it will be able to tell you and you'll be able to see it. So let's say we've got that going. That's fine, nothing's really gonna happen just yet. So what we actually need to do then is stop the container. So now we're gonna navigate to our folder, the app data folder that we created for the Plex Meta Manager app. Now in here, there are three files that we need to create. One is the config.yml, one is movies.yml, and the final one is tv.yml. Now on our documentation, we've actually got examples for you. So let's go and have a look at those. Now if you're following our documentation, you'll notice that on the sidebar, we've got the configs there. So let's start with configuration file. So this will be our config.yml, as we've described in the top here. Now, as we've written, be sure to update all the fields relevant to your environment, including but not limited to all these parts. So of course, instead of having hashes for a token, make sure you're putting in the correct tokens. But let's go through it together and I'll help explain what it's doing. So as we cruise through the file, we're going to be looking at these things here. So this is our libraries. This is where we're mapping the libraries that we have. This needs to match the name of your library in Plex. So in my Plex environment, the movies library is called movies and TV is just TV. So in here, we then have a file. That's going to be the file that we have to create, and it's where it's referenced. So config at this stage, if you followed our setup, is our app data folder. So the root folder is appdata/plexmetamanager. Then we have the movies.yml file in there. We're then also saying we want to include these lists as well. Now, what are these lists? If you go to the GitHub, they've got some template lists of metadata that you can use. So if you don't want to set up your own, you can use these template ones that other people have created and added to the repository, which is really cool. So there are actually different types of ones you can get on there, different ones that you might want to use. So this is pretty customizable. I wouldn't say you have to use these sources. I'm just giving you a standardized list that you can use, and this comes from the original template. So in here, we've got movie charts, studios, IMDb genres, and people. And what it's saying is anything in our movies YML we want, as well as these. The same goes for TV, so there's our TV.yml, and we also wanted show charts and networks, for example. Then we get into some settings, so what kind of settings you want to change or modify. There is a whole list here that can be amended for your setup. Now, there are plenty of settings here, and I highly recommend you read the official documentation just to make sure you understand each particular function. Usually the name is pretty suggestive of what the parameter will do, but I highly recommend you still read it anyway. So once you're happy with all that, this one here, again, I've tested this myself and I've had no issues myself. So if you're happy to use this, this is what we're providing. But if you would like to change it, just make sure you understand what's going on. Under Plex, we want our URL. So make sure you configure your Plex URL with the port. Then you will need your Plex token. Now there's a variety of different ways to get your Plex token. So the best and easiest way I've found is to go into an item. Let's say this one here, click the three dots, go to get info, click on view XML. Once it opens in the URL bar, go all the way to the end and you'll see your Plex token at the end. Add the Plex token in here and then keep moving on. The next thing we've got is the movie database. So I highly recommend you create a free account there, create an API key and add that in here for yourself. Tortuli, same applies there. Make sure the URL and the API matches. Then do the same for radar. with radar and sonar, it's really important that the root folder location as well as the quality profiles match exactly what's in your application. So this is the quality profile I use, and this is what it's called. So I spell it exactly as is with spaces and all. And that's our root folder path inside of radar. Same applies to sonar, make sure you do that as well. And then you've got Trakt. So if you wanted to use Trakt, which we'll explain to you shortly, then you will need your client ID and client secret. If I go back to the main page here for documentation, we've also listed how to create the Trakt API. So that's what you put in, that's what you put into the redirect URI, click save, and it will give you your ID and secret. The next two files, we have some different versions for you. So the first version is what I'm using, and then the second version here is from our community member, Drazizi. So a big thank you goes to Drazizi for sharing his config and helping actually create this documentation. Quite often we'll ask the community if anyone is knowledgeable on a particular subject and wants to help create the documentation. And that just means we can help better represent what the community understands and what the community wants to see. So thank you very much for your contribution. We really appreciate it. So here's what our TV YML looks like. Now in here, there's nothing that needs to reference the sonar or anything like that. However, you might want to change certain names of things. For example, if you wanted this collection to be called, you know, IBRACORP Popular, then you might want to change that to IBRACORP Popular. And as you roll down, then you can see all the stuff that's in this file. Now, like I said, if you have something that's not part of the original templates, but you want to set it yourself, this is how you do it. You've got the Emmy winners, for example, registers a template, then it asks what the list is that we're using. So then it's basically got a URL directly to that list. And the summary is the description that people see when they click on the collection. Now, if we look at Drazizi's TV config, you can see it's a lot more cleaned up and, you know, very specific to what his interests are. So as we can see here, we've got template studio collection. There's the different studio collections and general collections that he's got in there. We've also then added editing TV series metadata. So in this YAML, you can see how to sort titles are set for multiple shows, as well as adding custom names and summaries for each of their seasons. So as you can see, you can customize it the way you like and have it reference that data in multiple levels. Here's some extra examples we've provided for you as well. Again, thanks to Drazizi, he wrote these parts up. Then there's also setting up custom TV episode orders. So if you had a specific order that you wanted something to show up in Plex, it will actually override Plex's automated metadata agent. So it is quite a powerful application, and that's why you need to be very careful, because it can mess up your library if you are not careful. After TV set up, then we've got our movies config, and this will be our movies.yml. And same thing applies, guys. We've got a template here for you to use, and if you like it, use it. If you want to customize it, go for it. Drazizi also added his as well. There is one extra thing that really stood out to us from Drazizi that we really appreciated, and that's this holiday movie collection. So if you want, for example, to have lists run for holidays, a collection that's just for holidays, for example, Christmas, and every year you want it to refresh for Christmas and have, you know, top trending Christmas movies or whatever the case might be, this is the one for you. Every season you can just go and say, I want this collection to show up on my Plex users homepage. A lot of instructions there, and it's very, very detailed. So I highly recommend you follow that through if you're interested in setting up the holiday collections. So once you've created our three files, that's the main configuration done. Now the rest of it is pretty much, hopefully, fingers crossed, automated. So if we scroll down, we'll follow our documentation here as it says. So we've gotten up to this step. We've created the three files and we've made sure it all matches what we want. If you wanted to use Trakt, then we need to authenticate it. So as it says, we'll stop the container and follow the instructions for either Trakt or MyAnimeList and add the relevant values to your config YML. Now we've already done that because we've done the file first. So on your first run, like I said, we'll start it up, click on it again and go to the console. Once we run this command, on the first run, it's going to ask you to authenticate with Trakt. You click on the link, as it says, and it will take you to another page to sign in with Trakt, and Trakt will ask you for your permission, in which case you allow it, and then the script will pretty much proceed. You only need to do it once, and once it's done, you're right to go. Now, believe it or not, guys, that's pretty much it, because if you've configured the files, that's gonna go ahead and work. But I'm gonna show you a couple of other things that are really, really important. So believe it or not, guys, that's pretty much it. Once you've done this, it will start creating your collections for you. So there's a lot of things it can do. So let's have a look at the config real quick. And let's have a look at sonar, for example. You can see there's a few parameters here. These are some important ones. So the first one we're gonna see is search. So do we want, when PMM runs and says it runs a list of IMDb's top 250 movies, it'll check Plex You'll find which of those 250 movies you already have and put them in a collection. Let's say 150 of those movies are missing. Do we want that to be added to Radar? And then do we want Radar to go ahead and search for it? The other way around is, do we have content in Plex that's not in Radar and not in Sonar? So then it will actually allow you to add that content to Radar and Sonar. You can even say, do you want it to be monitored? You know, maybe you want it to add something but not actually monitor it. We can do that. So we've got add, which is false, and then we've got monitor, and then we have search. So you have all three levels there as separate parameters and that the script can actually run for us. So using this particular config file that I've used, it actually took me about 3 hours on the first run and about 2 hours on the second run after doing all the renaming that I needed to do. So it can take some time, but if we have a look here under movies, we've got our collections, and then under TV, we've also got our collections too. Now, if you're a Plex user and you want these collections to show up on your users' homepages, the process is pretty simple. Go to the collections view in the three dots section here. We'll click it, click on visible on, and then pick where you'd like the collection to show up. Once you've ticked these three boxes, if we then go to settings, go to libraries, then under the libraries, if we click on manage recommendations, these are the lists that we've created. From this point, you can then, you know, change the order that you want them to appear in, or whether you want them on just your home screen or your users' home screens, for example. So if we go back to home, we can see all of our collections that we've created right here. So another good one, for example, would be doing that for the Christmas collection. So if you wanted all your Christmas movies, you know, maybe the 1st of December, you could go in and assign that to your users so it shows up on their homepage. You've got control of that and you can manage it the way you like. And I mean, as you can see, it really gives the user a better experience with Plex and makes it feel a lot more like the big names, for example, Netflix, where you can actually break down into different categories and pick ones that you like. You know, in our scenario, we've got even by studios, we've then got our genres, we've then even got by actors, you can go by directors, producers, whatever you want, however you want to set it up. So guys, that was Plex Meta Manager. I hope you really enjoyed it. I was rapt when I stumbled across it last week and really put some time into it and spoke with our community. I think it really deserves some attention. It isn't the simplest thing to understand at first, but as usual here at IBRACORP, we try to make it as easy as possible for you guys to pick it up where we might have struggled. So I hope this video got you going and got your library looking really, really nice. If you have any more tips for PMM that you think others should know, please drop it in the comments below. We'd really appreciate it. Please also feel free to join us in our Discord. We'd love to have you there. We're going to keep the content coming and we have a lot of updates coming up. We're especially looking for ways to improve our documentation as well as finding all of our different IBRACORP services. So that's all a work in progress. Thank you very much for watching and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.